All right, everybody. I'm Ryan Monster DC. This is NHL 24 via pro mode. My currently career in this new game. We are in the Memorial Cup. We played three games. We got 4 goals, 2 assists, 6 points, and we're not too bad as we're going through. We're in, I think, the semifinals now, I believe. And let's jump into it. Let's see what happens. Like, comment, subscribe. As always, we're going to be putting up my whole career up on YouTube, so do check it out and all this. You're going to hear me rant and rumble and grumble all throughout these videos. So leave me a comment below. Let me know which team, if you're playing Be A Pro, which team drafted you in the Be A Pro mode. And we'll take it from there. Let's play.
Everybody, welcome back to EA Sports and two of the best in junior hockey ready to go tonight here in this Memorial Cup matchup. Moves the puck up to Bugat. Sends the pass over. Ottawa's got the puck. Puck dumped in. The Redhawks have it behind the cage. Takes the shot. Tremendous stop by Rousseau. Oh, and another big stop. There's the whistle as the goalie hangs on. Lots of time left in this period. We've still got zeros on the board. Quebec's won the draw. Slides it across to Savoie. Quebec's got the puck along the wall. Feeds it down low. Quick pass to Savoie. Takes the feed at the point. Denies him! He got off! And they'll cover it up, forcing a stoppage in play. The Remparts take possession here inside the offensive zone.
Ooh, off the post. Go, 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 go.
On the attack into the offensive end, right up the gut. For the low slot, denies him. Hammers it on net. Oh, it stops him again. And the puck stopper jumps on top of it to get a stoppage in play.
It's a pretty weak slap shot.
Works it across to Gaudette. Carries the puck inside the neutral zone. I don't think anybody was hanging on to the puck after that hit. And he takes the feed. Strong defensive effort.
I was hoping him to pass across.
We got a stoppage in play.
Would have been an interesting broken play on that one.
Okay, it's won it in their own end. Pokes it away to keep the pressure on. Trouchel's got it from behind his own net. And he takes the pass.
Oh, that's close.
Well, you work so hard to get these opportunities, and you have to find a way to execute and take advantage of your position on the ice.
We're still in the early stages of this period. Still no score in this one. Rochette's won a big draw in their own end. Bolduc's got the puck in his own zone. With possession along the wall. And that caroms off a body in traffic. Ottawa's got a hold of the puck now. Down the left wing, across into the offensive end. Here's a feed.
Oh.
What a finish.
I'll take
play.
It. That was good. We scored while lying down on the ground.
Although this is an unlucky bounce for the goaltender, James, it's one he'll want back. These are the types of goals that can be deflating for a team. It's a scramble in front. Goaltender can't find it. And guess what? It's in the back of the cage.
We'll take it.
Good start in this one, and they have certainly accomplished that with the first goal of the game just minutes in.
Well, you know, they would have talked about making sure that they established some presence and some pace in the game, in particular in the opening frame, James. But to get up a 1-0 lead on your opponent just minutes into the game, that is a fantastic start.
Puck grab by Tolney. Ottawa's got it in their own zone. The 67s take it along the wing. Pokes it away here in the neutral zone. Ottawa's got a hold of it along the wall. Takes a shot. Denied with the blocker. There's the whistle as the puck
is frozen
up.
Come on.
Toldai's been lighting the lamp with this point streak, playing so confident. He knows where he is on the ice, and it just seems that every time it makes its way towards the net, the puck's going in.
Ottawa's got the lead here in the first, as they have been the more dominant team in the offensive area. Savoie's moving the puck to his own zone. Now over to Truchel. Jostled off the puck.
Oops, passed it the wrong way.
Taken along the wall by Smith. The 67s move the puck in the defensive zone. Still has possession. Puck picked up by Roy. Oh, and a busted twig on the play.
Well, how frustrating is that, James? You get yourself to a great position, and then it snaps in half.
Answered the call on that play. Good read with the stick to break that up. And he takes the dish. Stopped by the goaltender. He got a little piece of that one. Moves it quickly over to Wah. Through the neutral zone and into the offensive end. Shot! Stopped by the goaltender. From the right side, moves it up ahead. Great heads up play to poke it away in the offensive end. Puck sent down the ice. We'll get an icing. Still lots of time left here in this frame. We've got a 1-0 hockey game thus far. Gauthier's won the faceoff.
Huge win by the center to give his team an opportunity to get out of the zone after a critical icing.
Here's a chance! Off a stick and they can't complete the play. That's moved up ahead.
That stretch pass was a beauty, James.
Big stop right there. They go on the attack through center. Along the half wall with the puck. Let's see what the officials are calling.
Tripping.
Well, this is a critical juncture of the game. You've got the one goal lead, and now you take a penalty. The PK unit has to be the task and kill this off.
Ottawa's got it in their own zone. The 67s take it across the line. Makes the save. He tries to tuck it in. Denies him again. Nice zone entry from the right side. Shot. Big save by the goaltender watching that one. More than half the period has gone by. Hope you're enjoying this one. 1-0 the score. Play resumes as they win the draw here inside the offensive zone. Moves the puck along the half wall. Moves it to Langlois. Here he is in front. Oh, it stays out. He got a piece of that one. And he takes the feed. Ottawa's got the puck against the boards.
I'm going to have to change this passing.
Shot from the wall. Makes the save. Picked up along the boards by Constantini. Handles the pass.
Change up.
The 67s played along the wall. And he comes up with it. Oh, spectacular save on the play.
I'm not sure where the defense is, but I'll tell you what, the goaltender has been outstanding, made a flurry of saves to keep his team in this one.
There's the buzzer. Fans seem to enjoy that first 20 minutes. We'll get to the second period right after both teams get a chance to catch their breath. Stick around. We are about ready to get underway here for the second period. Quick feed to Robidoux. On the attack along the boards.
Ottawa's looking to break out. Can't keep a hold of the puck after that play. All alone! Stopped on the breakaway! What a save he made there!
Well, I loved how he challenged the shooter on this, James. He didn't sit back in his net. He came right out to the top of the paint and said, if you're going to beat me, you got to find room.
Redirect in front. Goalie makes the save.
I really like the save, James, because he challenges the shooter who's all alone in the slot area. He turns aside a real dangerous opportunity.
Ottawa's been the more aggressive team offensively, and they continue to lead here in the second. The Remparts win the draw. Now let's see what they can do with it. Goalie with a stop. Slick feed. Here's a shot. Denies him on the slapper. In front, and a stoppage on the play as the goaltender covers things up. Lots of time left in this period. The 67s have taken a 1-0 lead. He looks deep to Malatesta. Takes the feed. Cuts it away in his own end. Ottawa's moving it along the wing. The Remparts have it now. Quebec's got the puck in the defensive end. Loses his balance on the play. Quick feed to Savoie. Takes the puck and will retreat back to his own end. And he slides it quickly to Malatesta. Quebec's got it into the offensive zone. Ottawa's got the puck along the boards. And it's a quick pass to Tolnai. Up along the wall on the right side and into the attacking area. Centering pass! And that doesn't go as it's off a stick. Through center along the wing. Looking to make something happen in the offensive zone. Here's a short pass to Robidoux. The 67s have it against the wall. Here they come. They've got numbers. From the left side, he moves it up ahead. And gets it deep inside the offensive zone, allowing them to get a breather. Quick pass to Beck. They've got the defense outnumbered. Sends it out front. And he shuts down a great scoring chance there. The 67s gain possession along the wall. Grabbed along the board by Rochette. Takes a bump but still hangs on to the puck. And that one's stopped. Tremendous pressure here in the offensive end. They're coming in waves. Takes it in the corner. Easy on the play. Gaining speed through center, and here they come on the attack. Shot, and he's right there with the blocker to keep it out. Ottawa's got it along the wall. The Remparts will play the puck from behind the net. Takes it across the blue line. Drives to the sweet spot. Grabs it with the glove. Ottawa's been rewarded for their high activity in the offensive zone with lots of shots, and they lead it here in the second. Gauthier's won the faceoff here in the offensive zone. And that shot goes nowhere as the lane was filled. Moves it around along the half wall. And he makes the easy save. Savoie's got it in the defensive end. Moves it quickly over to Thompson. And the goaltender grabs that one for a whistle to try to slow things down here. Past the halfway mark of this period, the 67s lead this one 2-0. Ottawa's got the puck after winning the defensive zone faceoff. And that pass goes off a stick. Quebec's got a hold of the puck. Now a quick pass to Thompson. Play is whistled dead as the puck goes up and over. Both teams are set. They're ready to drop the puck. possession of the puck after that center ice faceoff. Quebec's got the puck here in the open ice. Komarov's taken down to the ice. We got a penalty coming up. Time for the officials to hand out the judgment. The 67s are going to be shorthanded because of a tripping call. Another scoring opportunity looms here.
Power plays, more time on the ice, the ability to get that puck moving. These players know exactly what they're doing. They work on it in practice, spoke to some of them earlier today at the pregame, and they talked about the execution and the precision in particular with their puck movement.
Go, go, go! Moves it to Rochette. Oh, love the defensive stick work there to poke that one away. Tries to get it over to Boucher. And the long-range shot goes off target. The Remparts gain possession of the puck here in the offensive end. And the Lions clogged up blocking that.
Cold eyes standing up, ready to go.
Taken by Roy.
Certainly will, James. That puck is following him around, and you can see he saw the opening, but wasn't able to put it on net.
Oh, he just got enough of that to keep it out. They just keep coming in waves here in the offensive end, and they'll end all that pressure as they clear the zone. The 67s take it along the wall. Oh, how did he get a glove on that? What a stop by Rousseau. Past the midway mark in this period, we've got a 2-0 game here tonight. Sends one up to Bolduc. On the attack, they come down the right wing. Takes a hit, he goes down to the ice and coughs up the puck.
I have to look at the personnel to see who gets the advantage here, because it's coincidental, but it's who the team loses that really matters.
Batten down the hatches. Things should open up here with a little 4-on-4 on the ice. Ottawa's got it in the offensive zone.
The 4-on-4 is similar to 3-on-3. There's more ice available, and you can't just dump it in. You want to possess the puck and try and create numbers around the ice. That's 2-on-1s all over.
Tipped in front. Beautiful stick save to keep them from lighting the lamp.
Now the shooter's going to run out of real estate because he does a great job of getting out of top of the crease and taking away all the room. When you make yourself as big as possible, there's less holes in the net.
In the final moments of this period, Ottawa's got some breathing room as they lead it 2-0. Back underway, and they take possession here inside the offensive zone. Goaltender covers up and will get a faceoff. Moments away from the face-off, let's get back to the action. The 67s will start off on the attack after winning the draw. And a great read to turn that play aside. The 67s take it along the wall. Knocks the puck away in the open ice. Picked up along the wall by Messier. The Remparts get a hold of it. Puck is picked up here in the neutral ice by Savoie. Puts it on net, and that goes off the face of the goaltender.
Off the face of the goaltender.
As big as possible, and it usually
whoops.
Hits other parts of the body, but this one rattles right off the cage.
The 67s win it. Oh, a clutch save! Centering pass, and that's stopped. And he slides it quickly to Malatesta. Looking to make something happen along the boards. Denies him in close.
This is a fantastic save, James. He's all over it. What I mean by that is he knows exactly where it is and where it's moving. A reason why he can get square to it and make the save.
Ottawa's across the blue line. Pass back to the point. Swatted away with a stick.
As a goaltender, you have to be able to read and anticipate the play. He does it perfectly and is able to negate the shot.
Kershaw's got a hold of the puck behind his own cage. Scooped up along the wall by Rochette. Ottawa's got control of it now here in the offensive end. And he stopped that one. The Remparts have it now. Broken up with the stick in the defensive end. Directed over to Beck. Johnson. And tries to make a diagonal pass to Agostino. Takes the puck. Slides the puck over.
Such an impressive save. Love looking at this one again, James. You know that this goaltender is dialed in, so focused when they're doing everything to get to the puck and keep their opponent at bay.
The Remparts win the draw, and they go on the attack here in the offensive zone. Ottawa's moving it into the offensive end. Quebec's gained possession along the boards. Ottawa's got possession here in the offensive zone. And down he goes as the puck goes free. Slides it over to Thompson. Across the line, along the left wall. Ottawa's looking to break out of their own end. We got a whistle, penalty coming up.
Another stick infraction, and you know that coaches don't like this one. A product of not being in good position, reaching, and then taking the trip because you weren't moving your feet.
And that brings the period to an end. All right, third period just around the corner. We'll get a clean sheet of ice. I'm going to get more popcorn, and we're coming back with much more next. Rochette's recognizing they're still shorthanded here as they get ready for the faceoff. Quebec's penalty killers have their work cut out for them here. But a nice start to the period as they win the draw. And that's off a stick. Oh, what a save in front. The 67 scoop it up along the boards. Looks to set up at the point now. Too much traffic in the lane. Savoie's got a hold of the puck behind the net. Sends it over to Bolduc. The 67s get a hold of the puck along the boards. Along the side, here they come through the neutral zone. Quick shot, and he gets a chunk of that to keep it out.
Well, these are the saves when you know that your goaltender is dialed in, James. The ability to get to the top of the crease and be square to the shooter, that's a great save.
And now he moves it quickly to Trouchot. He grabs the puck here at the point. And kept that one out of the net. Poked away at center by Trouchot. Stopped by the goaltender.
Thompson's almost back on the ice.
Takes it at center. Takes a shot. Turns him away. The Remparts PK unit delivers on that.
Although they're still trailing, this game is now within reach with that effective kill. That gives life to the entire bench.
Thompson's exploring options with the puck. And the traffic jam.
Nope.
Blocks the shot. There's the whistle as the puck stopper elects to
almost walked right in there.
Lots of hockey left to be played in this period, and it's a 2-0 hockey game. Slides it diagonally to Savoie. Quebec's on the attack. And he's tripped up on the play. Referee's hand goes up here. There's the whistle. Let's get the official decision. The 67s are going to be shorthanded as they are called for tripping. Quebec's got the puck inside the offensive zone. And too much traffic in front blocks that one.
Damn. 2-1. 2-2. Oh, crap. Tie game again.
There's the buzzer. 60 minutes of play has solved absolutely nothing. So let's go to overtime. And we'll do that next here on EA Sports. Officials are ready to drop the puck here in overtime. Will we get a winner? Time to find out. It's overtime. Malatesta's going to play it against the half wall. Gets in front of it. Puck is frozen, and we get a stoppage in play. This is a face-off. They'll definitely want to win here inside the offensive zone. Ottawa's taking possession in their own end. Gaining momentum along the wing. And he was ready for that one. Oh, and he makes another save. Unreal pressure. Denied by the defender. Nice block. The 67's looking against the half wall. Quebec's got control of it now from their own end. Through the middle of the ice, they enter the attacking zone. Slides the puck down low. Quick feed to Malatesta. Oh, he stops it with the glove. Great reflexes there. A critical draw here. Ottawa's going to start with the puck in their own end. Takes the feed. The 67's played along the boards.
Wow, where's my rebound?
Covers it up. We get a whistle to slow things down. A lot on the line here in this offensive zone faceoff. Ottawa's won the faceoff. Quebec's got the puck inside the defensive zone. Look at this down the right wing. They're on the attack. The 67's gained control of the puck against the wall. Ottawa's got it in their own zone. Looks to make a play over to Tolnai. Back to the blue line. And makes the save. And we get a whistle as the goaltender decides to hang on to this one. A fake faceoff here inside the offensive end. Slides it over with pace to Malatesta. Robidas got it against the boards. Shot! Too many bodies in the way. The 67's moving ahead. Here they come on the attack. From a tight angle, throws it on net. Denied that one. Grabs control of it at the point. The 67's gained control of the puck.
Oh, went the wrong way.
The offensive end. And now he angles it across to Savoie. Big play inside the defensive zone. Look at that!
Left there wide open.
Despite the fact that they're going home as a team, I'll tell you what, I would think scouts were left with a pretty favorable impression with the one guy they came here to see.
There were lots of people discussing in and around this tournament what the draft eligible would be like. Like, how do they play the mark against older kids in a big game setting? And he acquitted himself really well.
There's zero chance
that the scouts of various teams that are going to draft around his area aren't interested in him. He had a good tournament.
Yeah, no, it certainly saw his stock go up big, big time. Let's take a quick break here on the show. More with Ray Ferraro.
Branding.
As we bring Ray Ferraro back into the show, how are you, sir?
All good.
Awesome.
All good.
You know, we talked so much about kind of the draft rankings. What do you make of the kids so far here in this tournament?
Well, it's an interesting time for a kid going into into his draft that he now knows is just a month or so away. I think he's played well enough that his draft stock's probably climbed a little bit. It puts himself into the position to be a higher selection draft. I would say upper end of the first round is where I think I can picture him.
Yeah, no, I certainly like the way he's. You know, a couple of other players we've been keeping close tabs on. All right, Razor, channel your inner bird dog here. What'd you think of the kid as his performance at the Memorial Cup?
Liked it a lot. Really bullish on the way that he played. For a young player, he took a leadership role. He was playing important minutes. Pretty interesting to see how much they lean on him. For me, this is a kid.
Good conversations in this game.
And the performance certainly backed that up. Thanks for this.
All right. Draft lottery results. Here are the draft lottery results. Chicago. All right. Well, I think we're going to Chicago, possibly. All right.
Ooh. And one of the interesting scenarios that I've heard was there were conversations between the youngster and the Chicago Blackhawks. Yes, an original six franchise, and you look at some of the veteran talent that they have on the roster and then some of the youthful movement that they're starting to work into this roster. How do I see that fit? That's an intriguing one for me with the Hawks possibly going after him in this potential scenario. So a lot of moving parts here, but I'm intrigued with Chicago on this one. What say you? How do you feel about these potential?
see what happens. Right, here comes fresh idea. Spend your days off. I try to get out. Try to get out and be active. Try not to overdo it.
I'm always interested when teams zone in on one.
Are you usually the highest rated player on your team?
In that particular case, waiting to see if that ultimately comes to light.
Let's try superstar on Allen. Ooh, now we're talking with the ducks. Quack quacks. GM Mia Lampman. I'm gonna ask you a few questions. Probably the same questions I got from Chicago. Is it a part game coming up? How do you prepare? Try to focus a little more. I need that extra edge. The same as every other game. I always come to play. That's a superstar on these guys. You don't always prepare to play at your hardest. What do you bring to the team? Let's cover it with that. Does it frustrate you when your teammates turn the puck over? Let's go with that. That's quite an interview thing. All right, so draft interview scored plus 21 on that one. All right, so we got the Chicago Blackhawks and the Anaheim Duckies. New conversation with the agent.
We inch closer and closer to the big draft day. And I'll tell you what, we look at some of the draft rankings and some of the scouts that I've talked to. I think we're all kind of on the same page. We've got this kid ranked pretty high, and he's put himself in a position to be a very high selection in that first round when we get to draft day. Keep an eye on him, mark my words. Anybody who passes on him.
Chicago. There we go. First all of all. Going to Chicago Blackhawks.
Getting our conversation with May Ferraro here on the show. Man, it's got to be a nice moment for the kid getting drafted and hear his name called.
It's better than that, Jason. Realization, really, a lifelong dream. I mean, since he's a little kid, he's been dreaming about getting drafted to the NHL.
Now, the understanding that we've got is that the kid was supposed to be heading down to the sometime day to kind of check out the new surroundings. This has got to be like the first day of school, Razor.
Guaranteed he would have gone early to go and take a look at the locker room. You walk in there for the first time, you can't believe your lifelong dreams are about to happen.
And when you're looking around, I'm assuming, you know, is he thinking the nameplate might be up there?
Oh, you're hoping, but you know, yeah. He's going to learn. Those trainers don't miss very often. The jersey's right. Your name has never looked good as when it's on top of your stall. But what I remember, James, is the excitement, the nervousness, how scared you were. And then you're like, I'm in an NHL room. I can't believe it. It's the very best feeling that you can have till you step on the ice the first time.
A nice opportunity for management and their prized possession, the new shiny draft pick, to kind of have a chance to sit down and get an understanding of where each other kind of sits, what the respective expectations
watching
are.
Watching you press through the tournament, but I wanted to ask you personally, how would you describe yourself as a player? I'm a freaking superstar. I'd like to be the next superstar at all costs. I'm a flexible player and I can adapt depending on the situation.
It's ultimately on the player to ultimately deliver on
that. Yeah, let's try this one. Management about that.
Both sides feel very good about this fit based on everything that I've been told. All right, time for a quick break. We're coming back with much more. Well, there's your latest addition for your trivia question. Who's taken first overall in particular year? And there you have it, the answer date. And I tell you what, no argument on the side. I think this was a clear-cut choice. This kid checks all the boxes. And look, the third generational talent is thrown around way too loosely these days.
How do I feel?
But
I'm
like this kid. He's got a chance to be a
real
franchise player. And this organization finally has something to really build around
management.
And take this franchise and give this fan base really something to cheer about. All right, we'll break down some of the other notable selections. We'll do that next.
Oh, more conversations.
Signed, sealed, and delivered. Yes, the entry-level contract, better known technically as the ELC. Yeah, you know me. Is signed up, and now it's time to find out if you live up to the hype. I think fans will
see. We agreed to get you signed for $850,000 for 3 freaking years.
All right, enjoy it. The honeymoon's almost over because it's time to shine, and we'll find out in camp. All right, still to come here on the show. Our
buying a new puppy. Yeah, we'll look at that later. Yeah, it should be bringing us up to preseason. There we go. Sent to the next preseason game. All right. Well, there we have it. We have been officially drafted as number one, Chicago Bucks.